We're again have the opportunity to have Dr. Dragan Ivanov here from Novi Sad. He's a specialist for internal medicine and a professor at the University of Novi Sad in Serbia. And he's been lecturing internationally for more than 15 years, and we're very happy that we have the opportunity to have him here with us to present these important messages with us. So with that, I'd like to call forward Dr. Dragan Ivanov, and Walter Lukic will be translating.
Ja vas sve srdačno pozdravljam.
I greet you all.
Lepo vas vidjeti ovdje ponovo.
It's good to see you again here.
I moje zadovoljstvo da sada imam priliku.
And it's my privilege.
Da podelim sa vama jedne značajne informacije.
Important to share with you important information.
Koje nam mogu pomoći da živimo ovaj naš život zdravije i sa manje bolesti.
That we can live a life healthier and with less disease, so fewer diseases.
Nije lako danas nama savremenim ljudima.
It is not easy today for us modern people, modern men.
Sa svih strana nam vrebaju neke opasnosti koje napadaju i narušavaju naše zdravlje.
From all sides we see the dangers lurking and coming on us.
I mi, kao kažem, treba nam puno opreznosti i mudrosti da živimo ovaj naš život i da izbjegnemo brojne savremene bolesti.
So we need a lot of care and lot of attention to avoid many dangers that are surrounding us in modern age.
I pred nama je jedna tema koja treba da nam kaže u kakvoj su vezi naš životni stil i maligne bolesti.
So today we would like to deal with a topic which is entitled Malignant Lifestyle and Malignant Diseases.
Kancer ili maligna bolest je nešto što dodiruje svakog čovjeka.
So cancer is something that affects each one of us. Cancer affects everyone in our society. Almost every person has to confront cancer personally or with a family member or a close friend. Although cancer is the second most common cause of death in the world, there is a reason for hope and optimism.
I mislim da nema ni jedne druge bolesti koja izaziva zemlju i strah kod savremenog čovjeka.
I believe there is no other disease in our, that causes so much apprehension and anxiety as cancer. There is a sharp rise in malignant diseases in the last two decades. The diseases are increasingly moving towards a younger age despite diagnosis and development of new drugs.
Našli smo se u jednoj apsurdnoj situaciji.
We find ourselves in an absurd situation.
Mi vidimo da savremena medicina napreduje.
We see on one hand that the modern medicine is making advances.
Farmaceutska industrija izbacuje sve više novih i novih lekova.
Pharmaceutical industry is producing and bringing to the market more and more medication.
Uslovi života i higijene su sve na višem nivou.
So the conditions of life improving, hygiene is improving.
A ljudi sve bolesni i sve bolesni.
People appear to be more and more sick.
Gdje to greši savremeni čovjek?
So where does the modern man make a mistake?
Kako vrijeme odmiče?
As time goes on,
mi smo sve bolesni.
We seem to be more sick.
Naše telo ima sve više problema.
Our body has more and more problems and ailments.
A i duša savremenog čovjeka sve više
pati. But also the soul of the modern man suffers more and more.
Maligne bolesti jesu problem.
Malignant diseases are a serious problem.
Ali ako mi definišemo jedan problem,
but if we define the problem,
ako ga upoznamo,
if we get to know the problem,
mi smo već taj problem jednim dobrim delom i razrešili.
We have to a significant degree already solved the problem.
I kada govorimo o svim bolestima, posebno malignim,
and whether we talk about when we talk about any disease, especially about malignant diseases,
moramo biti oprezni,
we have to be very careful. Most ordinary people and medical professionals ignore their own individual own responsibility for the development of malignant diseases.
Ljudi kažu sudbina je to u pitanju.
Often people say it's destiny, fate.
Ili pak ne vredi, ja ne mogu ništa učiniti sa svoje strane.
Well, doesn't matter, I can't do anything about this.
Ne zaboravimo.
Don't forget.
Da se radi o našem zdravlju I životu.
It concerns our own life and our own
I zato ne smemo ignorisati našu odgovornost.
And therefore we should not disregard our personal responsibility.
Mi smo ljudi koji imamo, koji biramo.
We are human beings, we have choices, we can make choices.
Svakog dana mi pravimo sitne izbore.
So every day we make some small choices.
I ti sitni izbori,
and these small steps, choices,
imaju krupan efekat na naše celokupno zdravlje I našu budućnost.
On our entire health and our future. The common man feels helpless in a sea of carcinogens.
I kad mi upoznajemo sve ove kancerogene materije,
and once we get to know all these carcinogenic substances,
I kad vidimo da se nalaze svuda oko nas,
and once we find that they are all around us,
I mi se osjećamo bespomoćni u svemu tome.
We somehow feel helpless in all these environments.
I onda donosimo jedan rizičan I opasan zaključak.
Then we make one risky and dangerous conclusion. Risky attitude. I will never be able to avoid all these carcinogens. Then why should I even bother?
To je jedan opasan I pogrešan stav.
This is one very wrong conclusion.
Jer pokazano je,
because it has been demonstrated
naučnim istraživanjima,
by numerous scientific studies,
da što više izbegavamo kancerogene supstance,
the more we avoid carcinogenic substances,
da rizik za nastanak maligne bolesti drastično opada.
The risk for development of cancerous disease, malignant diseases decreases.
Činjenica da maligne bolesti izazivaju zemlju, strah I da nešto da ih se plašimo.
The fact that malignant diseases are causing or triggering fear and anxiety in us.
Ja sam po prirodi optimista.
I'm by nature I'm an optimist.
I oko 40% mojih pacijenata su pacijenti sa malignim bolestima.
And about 40% of my patients are patients with malignant diseases.
I kada razmišljam I posmatram maligne bolesti,
when I consider and look upon malignant diseases,
ja bi s vama podelio ipak jednu optimističku vest.
I would like to share with you a good news, optimistic news.
To je da, znači, nije sve tako crno I nije sve tako mračno kada govorimo o malignim
diseases. Not everything is as black as it may appear when we talk about malignant diseases.
Postoji good news about malignant diseases.
Yeah, you heard it. There is a good news about malignant diseases.
Ajde vidimo o čemu se radi.
Let's take a look.
Prva dobra vest.
First good news.
80% malignih bolesti mogu se sprečiti.
But 80% of malignant diseases are preventable.
Ovo je veoma važna informacija.
This is a very important information.
Druga, I mi ćemo u ovom predavanju govoriti upravo o tome šta mi možemo učiniti kao individue da bi prevenirali maligne bolesti.
So the second one, and we will be talking in this entire lecture what we can do to prevent the emergence of malignant diseases, so we will talk about the next one.
Druga, dobra vest.
Second good news.
Jeste ta.
Is the following.
Da dijagnoza maligne bolesti ne znači smrtnu presudu.
The diagnosis of cancer is not always a death sentence because an early diagnosis and a comprehensive treatment can lead to healing.
Ako se na vreme dijagnostikuje.
If it's detected on time.
Ako se primeni odgovarajuća terapija.
If appropriate treatment is applied.
Postojeća maligna bolest.
The existing malignant disease can be conquered.
Ajde idemo mi sad na onu lepšu I bitniju priču.
But let's move to the more beautiful, actually, more attractive and more important part of the story.
I to je priča kako mi možemo, ja.
And the question, and the story is,
svako od vas,
how
šta može I šta treba učiniti da bi prevenirao malignu
disease? How every one of us, what we can do to prevent development of malignant diseases.
U borbi protiv maligne bolesti.
Fighting malignant diseases.
Pronađena je čudesna pilula.
One miraculous pill was discovered. In the battle against malignant diseases, a miraculous pill was found, which one, when used, gave encouraging results.
U Kanadi ona se može nabaviti.
In Canada, you can obtain it.
Možete je vi također naći.
You can find it.
I koristiti.
And make use of it.
Cena,
the price,
je sasvim prihvatljiva.
Very, very acceptable price.
Hajde vidimo ime te tablete,
let's,
da vidimo.
Let's see what's the name of
the pill. Se sastoji.
What is it made of?
I da onda konačno tu tabletu mi primenimo.
So let us use that pill.
Interesovat se, tako?
Are you interested to find out what is it?
Svaka, zato ste došli, da?
You should came for that reason, for sure, yeah.
Okay.
Now let's go to it.
Plant-based vegetarian diet, or yeah.
Yes. So you see it, you hear it.
Znači, prvi sastojak te čudesne pilule jeste biljna vegetarijanska ishrana.
So the first main component of that magic pill is plant-based diet, vegetarian diet.
O ovom faktoru, preventivnom faktoru, govorit ćemo u drugom delu predavanja.
About this preventative factor, we will talk in the second part of the lecture today.
Zašto ta ishrana ima taj značaj?
Why this nutrition or diet has such an importance?
I, kažem, to će biti u drugom delu.
I will tell you a little later.
Drugi sastojak ove tablete,
second component of that pill ingredient,
jeste redovna fizička aktivnost.
Regular physical exercise.
To je ono što treba savremenom čovjeku.
This is what the modern man needs.
To je to ono što treba vama.
This is what you people in Canada need.
Kakve veze ima fizička aktivnost sa malignim bolestima?
So what kind of relationship exists between physical exercise and malignant disease?
I sa kojim bolestima je u najčešće vezi?
And with which diseases lack or exercise is mostly related?
Ajde da vidimo.
So physical activity has a preventative effect on breast cancer, endometrial cancer, ovarian tumors, prostate cancer, colon cancer, lung cancer. It slows progression and recurrence of the tumor.
Ovo su najfrekventnije maligne bolesti.
These are most frequent malignant diseases.
I upravo u prevenciji ovih malignih bolesti.
And exactly in prevention of these diseases.
Fizička aktivnost ima svoje mjesto.
Physical activity has a very important role.
Ja znam da fizička aktivnost ima veze sa našim mišićima.
I know that physical activity is related to our muscle work or muscles.
Znao sam da ima veze sa kardiovaskularnim sistemom.
Cardiovascular system.
Sa telesnom težinom, dijabetesom.
Our body mass, body weight. With diabetes.
Ali otkud veza fizičke aktivnosti i malignih bolesti?
How that connection between physical activity and malignant diseases?
To ću pokušati da vam objasnim.
I'd like to try to explain this to you.
Budimo malo koncentrisani.
Just be focused for a few moments.
Idemo da vidimo.
Let's go.
Nedovoljna fizička aktivnost dovodi do deficita kiselnika u ćeliji.
So, first step. Lack of physical exercise leads, or sedentary lifestyle, leads to the deficit of oxygen in the blood, in the cells.
Okay. Znači, to je informacija broj jedna.
This is the information number one.
Zašto dolazi do toga?
So why comes to this effect?
Mi, kiselnik se nalazi u spoljašnjoj sredini.
So oxygen is found in the outside environment.
I šta mi radimo?
So what do we do?
Mi uzmemo kiselnik, i ubacimo ga u pluća.
We take oxygen from the air, outside air, and ingest it, take it in the body.
Kako?
How?
Inspiracijom.
By inspiration, by breathing in.
I kiselnik dođe u naš grudni koš.
So, oxygen comes into our lungs.
I tu se nalazi on u plućima i prelazi u krv.
Yes, and it's found in the lungs and then is transferred into the bloodstream.
Ali to je početna stanica.
No, this is the first station.
Ja kad sam krenuo za Kanadu,
when I set out to come to Canada,
došao sam na aerodrom u Belgrad,
I came to the airport in Belgrade.
I to, ali to nije bila moja destinacija, trajna destinacija.
That was not my ultimate destination, this was the starting point.
Vancouver je bila moja.
I was flying to Vancouver.
Nije krajna destinacija.
Vancouver was my destination.
Nije krajna destinacija kiselnika tu, u grudima.
So, the final destination for oxygen is not to be in the lungs.
Šta je krajna destinacija?
What is the final destination?
Svaka ćelija.
Each cell in our body.
Ćelije se nalazi ćelije su udaljene od grudnog koša.
So these there are cells of our body that are at some distance from the lungs.
I šta je toga potrebno?
So what do you need?
Treba autobusi.
You need buses.
Koji će uzeti kiselnik.
That will take that oxygen.
I odvesti ga do svake ćelije.
And transport it to each cell in the body.
Ko su autobusi?
So what are the buses?
Eritrociti.
Eritrocyti.
Red blood cells. Yeah.
Red blood cells.
Ali njih treba neko da vozi, njih treba neko da pobura.
Someone or something has to put in motion these red blood cells.
Ko to radi?
And who does that?
Srce.
The blood.
Kardiovaskularni sistem.
The blood or cardiovascular system is...
Srčana pumpa. Srce se stisne.
As heart as a pump, which simply contracts and pushes these red blood cells
do svake ćelije
to each cell
iz grudo, iz grudi.
From our lungs, from here into the body.
Ali ako mi sedimo,
but if we sit,
ako nemamo dovoljno fizičke aktivnosti,
if we don't have enough physical exercise,
šta će se desiti?
What will happen?
Kiseonik neće. Pođe sporo da se dovozi do ćelija i u ćelijima će biti deficit.
Yes.
So biće slaba cirkulacija.
Oxygen will not move fast enough or sufficiently enough to the cells in the body and there will be deficit of oxygen in the body.
U sedećem položaju cirkulacija je jako sporo.
So when you sit, when in the sedentary position, the circulation, blood circulation is very slow.
I naše ćelije imaju deficit kiselnika.
And our cells have a deficit of oxygen.
I šta se onda dešava?
And what happens?
Idemo na sljedeći slide.
So we go to the next slide.
Idemo na biohemiju.
So we are now talking about biochemistry.
To ono što niko ne voli.
People don't like typically biochemistry.
Okay. Ali ovo moramo objasniti.
And let me just say something. When I was looking through the slides, I'm not a biochemist, so you will pardon me if I don't pronounce every term exactly.
Okay. Da bi ćelija živela,
in order for a cell to live,
ona treba energiju.
The cell needs energy.
Energiju ćelija dobija iz glukoze.
So the cell gets the energy from glucose.
I kada mi tankujemo ćeliju sa glukozom, sa gorivom koje se zove glukoza,
when we supply the cell with a fuel which is called glucose,
onda ćelija od glukoze stvori energiju.
So the cell transforms the glucose, uses it and creates energy, produces energy.
A kao nus produkt,
and as a byproduct,
šta se stvori?
What is created?
Ugljen dioksid,
carbon dioxide,
i voda,
and water.
Šta mi radimo s ugljen dioksidom?
So what do we do with carbon dioxide?
Izdahnemo ga.
We exhale, breathe out.
I gurnemo ga u atmosferu.
And we simply dispose it to the atmosphere.
I biljke gledaju nas ljude.
And the plants look at upon our humans.
Šta ga?
And they say,
konačno nešto mudro i dobro do ovog čovjeka.
So finally something good is coming from these people.
Obično seče, uništava. Obično seče, uništava.
Yeah, yeah. Men are typically cutting us down, trees and plants.
Ali evo, dao nam je ugljen dioksid.
And now the man is giving us the
carbon dioxide.
So what the plants do?
Evo, častit ćemo tog čovjeka, dat ćemo mu kiselnik.
So we will be kind and generous toward that human being. We will give him oxygen.
I proces fotosinteze.
So through the process of photosynthesis,
oni izbace kiselnik
čovjeka. The plants simply deposit or leave the oxygen for us.
Šta bi se desilo? Šta bi se desilo kad čovjek ne bi dao karbon dioksid biljkama?
So what would happen if,
šta bi se desilo kad,
if human beings would not release the carbon dioxide to the plants?
Kad bi čovjek uzeo oksigen, a ne bi dao karbon dioksid?
So what would happen if we would be taking oxygen from the plants and we would not release or return carbon dioxide?
Život bi se ugasio.
The life would slowly, you know, be extinguished. Die out.
Selfishness je suicidalna.
So selfishness is suicidal.
Ako uzimamo,
if we take something,
a ne dajemo,
and we do not give it in return,
mi uništavamo sami sebe.
We are simply destroying ourselves.
Mi živimo.
We live.
Existiramo.
We exist.
Ceo život na ovoj planeti existira.
The entire life in this on planet Earth
exists
on one principle.
Ako uzimaš,
if you take,
moraš i dati.
You have to give.
Ako uzimaš, a ne daješ,
if you take and don't give,
to je samoubistvo, odnosno smrt.
Brings death, brings, you know, any life.
Mi smo učili, mi smo učili spominjali, O dugovečnosti.
Yesterday we mentioned something about longevity.
I rekli smo da.
And we said.
Ko hoće dugo da živi.
Whoever wishes to live long.
Šta treba da radi?
Who, what he or she has to do.
Treba da daje.
To give.
A ne da čeka.
And not so much to expect to receive.
Jer darodavci duže žive nego oni koji čekaju.
They mentioned that donors live longer than people who are just getting things.
Tako je zivo, to sam biokemiju.
So what it has to do with the biochemistry?
Idemo na biokemiju.
Let's go to biochemistry.
Znači, glukoza uđe u ćeliju.
So glucose comes into the blood cells, into the cells.
Od nje se stvori energija.
And the energy is created.
I stvori se ugljen dioksid i voda.
So then we have carbon dioxide and water.
Ali pod jednim uslovom.
But for under one condition.
Ako u ćeliji ima dovoljno kiselnika.
This happens only if in the cell there is sufficient supply of oxygen.
Ako nema dovoljno kiselnika.
If we don't have sufficient quantity of oxygen.
Onda gledamo ovaj slide.
Then we look at this slide.
Postoje tako, onda u ćeliji postoje aerobni uslovi.
So then we have anaerobic conditions in the cell.
Znači, imamo uslove kad nema kiselnika u ćeliji.
So these are conditions when in the cell there is not enough oxygen.
I da bi ćelija preživjela.
And in order for the cell to survive.
Ona mora da aktivira jedan alternativni put.
Cell has to activate an alternative way.
To nije fiziološki put.
This is not physiological
way. To nije najbolji put.
This is not the best way.
Ali da bi ćelija preživjela.
But in order to survive the cell.
Ona stvara energiju iz glukoze.
It produces energy from glucose.
Ali bez prisustva kiselnika.
Without the presence of oxygen.
I nastane energija.
And then energy is produced.
Koja je upakovana u adenozin trifosfat.
Which is packaged in this ATP.
Ali šta stvori još?
It's phosphate and produces something else.
Šta?
Lactate.
To je kiselina, acid.
This is acid.
I ćelija, unutrašnja ćelija biva kisela.
Is it uric acid or?
No.
Okay.
Lactate.
Lactate. Okay, that's it.
Unutrašnjost ćelije je. Unutrašnjost ćelije je kisela.
The inside of the cell becomes acidic.
Ako su naše ćelije i naše telo kiselo,
if the interior our cells are acidic.
Nastaje jedan ozbiljan problem.
Then we develop a serious problem.
Ajde, u čemu se radi?
Let's see what is the problem.
Dr. Otto Heinrich Warburg je doktor koji je živio u Nemačkoj.
It's a medical doctor who lived in Germany.
Dobio je 31. godine Nobelovu nagradu iz fiziologije.
He was a Nobel Prize winner in 1931 in physiology. He discovered the cause of cancer in 1923.
I šta on kaže?
What does he say? What did he say?
Kancer nastaje u ćeliji.
Cancer develops in the cell.
Koja nema kiselnika.
That does not have sufficient oxygen.
I koja zbog toga postaje kisela.
And which because of that deficit becomes acidic.
Kancerogeno tkivo je kiselo.
So cancerous tissue is acidic.
Zdrava tkiva su alkaline.
Healthy tissues are alkaline.
Ako mi nemamo fizičke aktivnosti,
so if we don't have physical activity,
naše ćelije, naša tkiva će biti kisela.
Our tissues, cells will become acidic.
I zbog toga,
and because of that,
šta?
What happens?
Nastaje kancer.
Cancer develops.
Kancer raste ili nastaje i razvija se.
So cancer develops, grows in acidic environment. So cancer grows, deprive a cell 35% of its oxygen for 48 hours and it may become cancerous.
Fizička aktivnost.
So, please remember, physical activity
donosi oxygen u svaku ćeliju.
Makes oxygen to the cell, to each cell.
I zahvaljujući tome.
And thanks to that process.
Ćelija se spašava. Ćelija neće biti kisela.
The cell will not become acidic.
Biće alkalna.
Will be alkaline.
I to predstavlja veoma značajnu prevenciju za nastanak malignih bolesti.
It presents a very important prevention mechanism for development of cancerous diseases.
Treba da održim dva predavanja.
Yeah, I was supposed to give you two lectures today.
Da, ja ću nekako pričati, pa ćemo napraviti malu pauzu.
I will talk and then I will make a little break.
5 minuta pauzu ću napraviti. Yeah. Tako da polako ću pričati. Evo jedna interesantna priča o ovome doktoru.
This is an interesting story about this doctor.
Jevrej.
He's a Jewish man.
Žive u nacističkoj Njemačkoj.
He lived in Nazi Germany.
Interesantno je da ga Hitler nije ubio.
Interestingly, the Hitler did not exterminate him. He sent him to the consulate.
Yes. Otkud to?
How?
Pa Hitler je imao jednu naslednu bolest.
Hitler suffered from a hereditary disease.
Koja se zvala?
Which was
polipoza debelog creva. Kolon polipoza.
Kolon polipoza of the. Yeah.
On je imao polipe na kolon.
He had polyps in his colon.
Nakon 5 godina polip se pretvara u kancer.
So about after five years the polyp can turn into cancer.
I kad se otvori polip,
when you excise or remove the polyp,
donekle se reši problem.
You, to some extent, you solve the problem.
Ali posle toga na drugom mestu rastu polipi.
But the polyps develop in other places.
I u njegovoj porodici bilo maligni bolesti.
So in his family there were malignant diseases.
I on je imao strahovitu fobiju od malignih bolesti.
So Hitler had an amazing phobia, fear of malignant diseases.
I kad je čuo za ovog čovjeka,
and when he heard about this man, this doctor,
on je rekao da ne smije nikoga da dira.
He said, no one should touch this man.
Zašto?
Why?
Ako dobije kancer,
if he gets a cancer,
on će ga liječiti.
This man will take care of him.
Yeah. Bolje da nije liječio, da.
Yeah. Maybe it's better if he didn't. It will be better if he didn't. But anyway, we don't want to speculate.
Okay.
So.
Znači, razumeli smo zašto fizička aktivnost ima preventivno dejstvo na kancer.
So now we understand why physical activity has a preventative effect on development of cancer.
Ako uzmemo jedan bodrani hormon koji se zove endorfin.
So if we take one brain hormone which is called endorphin,
i kad bismo to sad ubacili u krv, u organizam,
if we would inject that hormone into your bloodstream,
šta bi se desilo?
What would happen?
Posle 15 minuta svi bi bili veseli.
About 15 minutes, after 15 minutes all of you would become very happy.
Niko ne bi bio tužan i depresivan.
No one would be sad or depressive.
Imali bi više fizičke i mentalne energije.
You would have more physical and mental energy.
Naš imunni sistem bi se podigao.
Our immune system would be boosted.
Srce bi radilo jače.
Heart would work harder.
I još neke drugi efekti bi se pojavili.
Some other effects would develop.
Znači, endorfin ima fantastično dejstvo.
Has a phenomenal effect on our body, in our system.
Endorfini nas također štite od malignih bolesti.
But endorphins also protect us from malignant diseases.
A poznato je,
and it's known,
da fizička aktivnost,
and it's known that physical activity,
koja dovede do znojenja i do lupanja srca,
leads to respiration and higher heart rate,
podiže koncentraciju endorfina.
Elevates the concentration of endorphins.
I to je jedan od razloga zašto fizička aktivnost.
And this is another reason why physical activity also has preventative effect.
Čudesna pilula u borbi protiv maligne bolesti zove se.
Amazing pill in fighting the cancerous diseases is called
normalna telesna težina ili poželjna težina.
Normal, desirable body weight.
Znači, treba da imamo
we need to have
normalnu fiziološku telesnu težinu.
Normal, regular, physiological body weight.
Ovo preventivno sredstvo
this preventative method or means
je u najtešoj vezi sa prva dva.
It's closely, most closely connected with the first two we mentioned.
So, ishrano,
with the diet
i sa ovim
physical activity.
Ajde vidimo o čemu sad.
Obesity, malignant disease. Studies show that obesity is connected with certain hormone-dependent tumors such as breast cancer, ovarian cancer, and uterine cancer.
And prostate cancer also.
And prostate cancer too. So obesity is also associated with cancer of the liver, gallbladder, pancreas, colon, and kidney. More people have died due to food and drink than due to hunger and thirst. Periods of hunger and deprivation have brought humanity and something good.
Idemo dalje.
Breast cancer and obesity. Fat cells produce certain amounts of estrogen at the time of menopause. Obese women have excess fat cells thus excess estrogen at the time of menopause and thereby increase the risk of developing cancer. Vegetarians have a lower body weight.
Znači, gojaznost je u tesnoj vezi sa malignim bolestima.
So obesity is closely connected with malignant diseases.
I sad ćemo vidjeti koji još to faktor ima moćno preventivnu terapijsku dejstvo borbi protiv kancera.
So let us see which other factor also has a very powerful effect, preventative effect on malignant diseases.
To je vitamin D, odnosno sunlight.
So vitamin D, sunlight.
Vidimo o čemu se radi.
Let's see what we are talking about.
Kaže jedan naučnik,
one scientist mentioned,
teško je pronaći bilo koji hranjivi sastojak,
it is difficult to find any nutrient,
ili bilo koji drugi faktor,
or any other factor,
koji tako moćno i sistematično deluje u prevenciji raka, kao što vitamin D.
Which works so powerfully and effectively in prevention of cancer as is vitamin D.
Deficit vitamina D u vezi je sa sljedećim malignim bolestima.
So, the deficit of vitamin D is related, associated with the following cancerous diseases. Breast cancer, ovarian cancer, prostate cancer, colon cancer, pancreatic cancer, and malignant lymphomas.
O čemu se radi?
So, what are we talking about?
Kad je pošlo ono elektronsko, kompjutersko skupljanje dijagnoza,
when we enter into the age of computerized digital collection of or creation of data for the diagnosis.
Vi znate da svaka dijagnoza ima svoju šifru.
So you know that every diagnosis has its code.
I kad se to sve skupi u jedan svjetski kompjuterski centar.
And when you put all this information in one computerized system.
I kad se onda analiziraju bolesti.
And when you analyze, do analysis of the diseases.
Gdje se te bolesti nalaze.
And where these diseases are located.
Došli smo do začuđujućih i zapanjujućih rezultata.
We came to amazing discoveries.
Šta se dešava?
What did we find?
Oko ekvatora i u tropskim predjelima,
around the equator and in tropical parts of the world,
maligne bolesti su izuzetno retko.
Malignant diseases are incidence of malignant diseases is very low.
Ako neko ima malignu bolest,
if someone has a malignant disease,
to je u vezi sa infekcijom sa mikroorganizmima.
Most often this is related to infection from microorganisms.
Hepatitisom C.
Hepatitis C.
I neke druge infekcije.
And some other infections.
Kako idemo od ekvatora prema severu?
As we move from equator up north to the north,
učestalost, frekvenca malignih bolesti se sve više i više povećava.
Frequency, incidence of malignant diseases increases more and more.
I bilo lako zaključiti.
And it was easy to make conclusion.
Što manje sunca?
The less sunlight.
Manje vitamina D.
Less vitamin D.
I više malignih bolesti.
More malignant diseases.
Od 100 pacijenata,
out of 100 patients,
koje ja pošaljem u laboratoriju,
that I sent for the lab test,
da izmere vitamin D,
to simply measure the vitamin D,
98 pacijenata imaju deficit vitamina D.
95 to 98 of these patients have vitamin D deficiency.
I to kakav izuzetno veoma izražen deficit.
What kind of deficiency? Very pronounced deficiency. High deficiency vitamin D.
Bez vitamina D,
so without vitamin D,
naš imunološki sistem umre.
Our immune system simply withers.
Kao i biljka što umre, umire, tako kolabira naš imunološki sistem.
So immune system collapses without vitamin D.
A kako je skup ovaj lek, da?
And how expensive is this remedy for medication?
Znači, sunce obasjava svakog čovjeka.
Sunlight is available to every human being.
Bio dobar.
Whether a person is good or bad.
Ali što mi radimo danas?
So what do we do today?
Sve smo učinili da pobjegnemo od sunca i sunčeve svjetlosti.
We have done everything possible to run away from sunlight.
stana uđemo u auto.
From our house or apartment we come in the cars.
Iz auta uđemo u kancelarije.
From the cars we go into the offices.
U toku godine odemo jedan put na godišnji odmor.
Throughout the year we go maybe once to hold holidays.
I šta radimo?
And what do we do?
Uzmemo kreme sa zaštitnim faktorima.
And then we take these sunscreens, you know, these high factors.
Koje opet sprečavaju da se sintetiše vitamin D.
Which also prevent synthesis of vitamin D in the skin.
A istovremeno propuštaju zrake koji izazivaju kancer kože.
And at the same time these sunscreens let go these rays, sun rays that are cancerous.
I kada odemo na sunce,
so when we go to the sunlight,
mi učinimo sve da vitamin D se ne sintetiše.
We actually do everything possible that we avoid synthesis of vitamin D.
Idemo dalje. U borbi protiv malignih bolesti pomaže nam melatonin.
In our fight or war against malignant diseases, another hormone, right? Another chemical is important, which is melatonin.
Yeah. To je hormon koji luči mozak.
This is a brain hormone.
Taj hormon se luči između ponoći i 3 sata.
This hormone is released between midnight and 3 in the morning.
Pod jednim uslovom.
Under one condition.
Da veštačka svetlost ne pada na naše oči.
That artificial light does not fall on our eyes.
Ako veštačka svetlost pada na naše oči.
If the artificial light falls, comes on our face or eyes.
I šibi se na je sinteza i lučenje melatonina.
This will inhibit or prevent synthesis of vitamin D.
I savremeni stil života.
Virtual of melatonin, yeah. And the modern lifestyle
nas je doveo u situaciju,
brought us into the condition
da i odrasli i mladi imaju ozbiljne deficite melatonina.
That both young and old have serious deficiency of vitamin D.
A kako da imamo melatonin?
And how to get melatonin?
Kada u to vreme sve manje ljudi, sve manje dece i ono ne spava.
Fewer and fewer people, young and old, fewer and fewer sleep at that time.
Veliki broj osoba između ponoći, u vremu ponoći, u jedan sat i dalje ne spava, nego gleda, čita, gleda televizor, kompjuter i pa ne
spava. Yes, a large portion of population, even after midnight, doesn't sleep, you know, watching TV or internet browsing or games or so on.
Osobe koji imaju veće koncentracije melatonina,
so people who have higher levels of melatonin,
duže žive,
live longer,
imaju veću fizičku energiju i snagu,
more physical energy,
i mozak im bolje radi,
and the brain works better,
i nisu depresivni,
they are not depressed.
Melatonin, to je što treba savremenom čovjeku.
Modern man needs it.
Kupujmo ga između ponoći i 3 sata.
So please make sure that you sleep between midnight and 3 o'clock where you can buy melatonin.
Čudesna pilula sadrži još jedan sastojak.
This magic pill contains another ingredient.
A to je antistresni program.
And this is anti-stress program.
I antistres program je posebna priča.
Management of stress is a special story.
Činjenica na fizička aktivnost.
Fact of life is the physical activity.
I vrsta ishrane.
And the proper diet.
Deluju na prevenciju ili na uzrok ili na nastanak stresa.
Are in direct relationship with the development of management of stress.
U drugom delu predavanja o tome.
In the second part I will say a little bit more.
Tableta koja ima moćno preventivno dejstvo na nastanak malignih bolesti sadrži još nešto.
The pill that has a powerful preventative effect on development of malignant diseases contains something else. Overcoming diseases related to drug addictions, tobacco, alcohol, drugs.
O tome ja ne bih sve nešto govorio.
I did not talk much about this.
O tome je puno napisano.
Much has been written about this.
I ja tu ne bih nešto se zadržavao.
I would not spend more time on this. It's well accessible.
Dakle, kad govorimo o malignim bolestima.
So when we talk about malignant diseases.
Šta mi treba da znamo?
What do we need to know?
Da nije sve tako mračno i strašno.
Not everything is so dark and bleak as may appear.
U Finskoj i u Americi su napravljeni preventivni programi.
So in Finland and the United States some preventative programs had been developed.
Korišćena je ova magična pilula.
Or this magic pill has been used.
I šta se desilo?
And what was the result?
Maligne bolesti počele su da padaju.
Malignant diseases began to decrease.
U Sjedinjenim Američkim Državama.
In the United States.
Brojna istraživanja su pokazala
numerous studies have shown
da postoji direktna veza između ishrane I malignih bolesti.
There is a direct relationship, a link between malignant diseases and diet. 35 to 60% in the United States of all deaths from cancer can be attributed to poor eating habits.
Nepromišljeni stil ishrane.
So, careless diet and the lifestyle
dovodi odgovorno je za 60% smrti
malignih bolesti. Is responsible for about up to 60% of malignant diseases. A lot of research shows the effects of diet on different types of cancer. However, what I found is that the effects of diet on cancer types is practically the same for all forms of cancer, regardless of whether they are initiated by a variety of factors and are located in different parts of the body. Colin Campbell.
Ko je Colin Campbell?
Who is Colin Campbell?
To je, možemo reći, po meni naj značajnije ime u medicini u drugoj polovini 20. veka.
According to my opinion, this is one of the most important names in the second in medicine in the second half of the 20th century.
Ovaj profesor doktor Colin Campbell,
this professor of medicine Colin Campbell,
on je bio prvi čovjek koji je otišao u zvaničnu posjetu Kine.
He was the first man who went to do a research in China.
Koji je dobio pasoš.
He got a passport.
I koji je otišao tamo da vrši, da vodi istraživanje o uzrocima, o uzroku malignih bolesti.
And he conducted a very serious research in China about the causes of malignant disease.
Kineski premijer Chu Enlai.
The Chinese prime minister Chu Enlai.
On je dobio malignu bolest.
He got cancer.
I pozvao je ministra zdravlja.
And he called his minister of health.
I dao mu partijsko naređenje.
And he gave him, you know, command to the party as a party
line. Da pronađe uzrok malignih bolesti.
To find the cause of malignant diseases.
I da pronađe lek.
And to find the remedy.
I krenulo jedno veliko istraživanje u Kini.
So a major research was launched in China.
800 miliona ljudi je učestvovalo u China study.
Wow. 800 million people were involved in this China study.
Dugo je ta studija trajala.
That study took a long time.
I kad su svi ti rezultati skupljeni,
when you gather all the results,
tim doktora Colina Campbella,
the team, the expert team of Dr. Colin Campbell,
napisao jednu knjigu,
they put together a book research,
i u svim medicinskim časopisima objavio rezultate.
In all scientific journals, that study was published.
I to je bio boom.
And this was a big thing.
Ali kratko vreme.
But for a short time.
Slomili su na stranu Colina Campbella.
Colin Campbell was put on the side.
I njegova istraživanja su budu na stranu.
His research was pushed aside.
Vidjet ćete zašto.
You will see why.
Ne zaboravite.
Don't forget.
Ovo ime I ovu knjigu.
Don't forget this man, name, this man and his book.
Ima elektronski oblik ta knjiga.
This book is also available in a digital form.
Također, puno prezentacija I govora na YouTube ima ovoga.
You can find many interviews and talks on that topic on YouTube as well.
I slušajte malo ovo.
And listen what people, knowledgeable people can say about this.
Evo da ima što on kaže, kakva veza postoji
između ishrane. Let's see what Dr. Campbell says about the link between diet and malignant diseases.
O tom ćemo govoriti.
We'll talk about this now.
Šta treba da jedemo, šta ne treba da jedemo da bi sprečili maligne bolesti.
What we should eat and what we should not eat to prevent malignant diseases.
I potom,
and then,
da vidimo,
to see,
kako ishrana,
how our diet,
deluje na naše emocije I na naše mentalne
procese. What kind of effect the diet has on our mind, on our mental processes.
Ja sam se začudio I zadivio.
Surprised or admired, right?
Kada sam video da ono što jedemo deluje na naše emocije I na naše raspoloženje.
When I saw how much what we eat, what kind of effect it has on our emotions and our state of mind.
Ono što jedemo danas,
what we eat today,
sutra, u bukvalnom smislu, to mi postajemo.
In literal sense, what we eat today, we become tomorrow.
Sutra mi postajemo ono što smo danas jeli.
We are becoming that what we ate today.
Ej, da, ti sastojci hrane postaju naše ćelije i naša tkiva.
These ingredients of food, these nutrients are actually becoming part of our body, of our mind. Today's man is denied information that is of utmost importance for his health. We are speaking about the inadequate knowledge of the medicinal properties of food and the dangers of today's dietary habits. And this is true.
Mi znamo šta rade, sportisti.
We know what the people in the sports.
Mi znamo mnoge informacije iz samo nekog pikantnog privatnog života glumaca i igrača.
Details from the lives of people who are in,
actors
and celebrities.
Ali u vezi ovoga.
But about this.
Mi mnoge informacije ne znamo.
Many information. Much information is not known.
I kad ja gledam šta ljudi jedu.
And when I see what people eat.
Složio sam se sa jednim poznatim doktorom.
I agree with one of well-known doctor.
Šta kažem?
Many are eating harmful foods.
Mnogi se hrane katastrofalno.
Many people are eating just disastrous diets.
Hajde da pogledamo iskreno istinu u oči.
So, let us look into the eyes of our diets.
Kako se mi to hranimo?
So how do we eat?
Veliki broj ljudi hrani se katastrofalno.
So large number of people are eating disastrously.
95% bolesti su u najtešnjoj vezi danas, u najtešnjoj vezi sa izbornom hranom.
95% of diseases are most closely related to the diet. Or the selection of food. More than 95% of chronic diseases are caused through the selection of food, which contains toxic ingredients, and it's lacking nutritious components, and through a lack of physical exercise.
Postoji jedna velika i opasna zabluda.
There is a serious error about diet.
Ta zabluda i ta greška vezana je za proteine.
So this error, this is closely associated with proteins or meat. This is a meat.
Znači mi pravimo ozbiljne greške po pitanju unosa proteina.
So we make serious mistakes about the intake of proteins.
Proteini jesu važni.
So proteins are important.
I kada čula to mesna industrija, mlečna industrija.
And the meat industry and the dairy industry heard about the importance of proteins.
Oni su nas počeli bombardovati sa tim jedite proteine, jedite proteine.
They started to bombard us with these messages, eat proteins, eat proteins.
A najviše proteina ima u mesu i mleku.
And most proteins are found in meat and dairy products.
I onda su nastali brojni problemi.
And then developed serious problems.
Današnji stil ishrane u Kanadi.
So contemporary lifestyle and diet in Canada. Characterized by
da 40% energije potiče 40 pa i više posto energije potiče iz proteina.
About 40% or even more than 40% of energy derives from proteins.
A treba da bude oko 10 do 12% energije da potiče
od proteina. But it should be only 10 to 12% of energy should derive from proteins.
3 do 4 puta više unosimo proteina nego što treba.
So we are intaking 3, 4 times more proteins than we need.
Kaže jedna izreka.
There is a proverb.
Iz farmakologije.
From pharmacology.
Sve je lek.
Everything is a remedy or medication.
Sve je otrov.
And everything is a poison.
Razlika je u dozi.
The difference makes the dosage. The dosage makes a difference.
Proteini jesu važni.
So proteins are important.
Ali ako ih unosimo 10 do 12%, to je dobro.
If we just have 10 to 12% of energy, total energy intake is from proteins, that's fine.
Ali mi ih unosimo 40-40%.
We have 40 to or more percent of energy comes from proteins, that's wrong.
Verovanje da nema proteina bez mesa.
So there is a common widespread belief that you cannot get proteins if you don't eat meat. The typical diet leads to excessive protein intake, primarily due to daily intake of meat, which has dangerous consequences.
I jedna od tih konsekvenci,
and one of these consequences
jeste
is
cancer.
Is cancer.
Cancer je u najtešoj vezi sa unosom animalnih proteina.
Cancer is in the most, in the closest association with the intake of animal proteins from meat. Animal protein encourages cancer growth. And this is Dr. Campbell, that is right.
Jedan od najtoksičnijih sastojaka ili nutritijenata savremenog čovjeka,
one of the most toxic nutrients of modern man,
jeste animalni protein.
Is the animal protein.
A nas su ubeđuju i stalno pričaju da su animalni proteini nešto najbolje i najidealnije za našu.
And we have been persuaded for decades that animal proteins are the best proteins you can get.
Posebno su opasni animalni proteini, meso koje je na ražnju.
Especially dangerous are the animal proteins that are grilled meats. The amount of benzopyrin in 1 kilogram grilled meat is equal to amount present in 600 cigarettes.
Benzopyrin je dokazani kancerogen.
So benzopyrin is a proven cancerogenic substance.
Skroz kože, želuca.
For the mucosa of the stomach.
Kolona.
Colon.
Pankreas.
Intestinal walls in some pancreas.
Liver.
Liver.
Još jedan pomoć, pročitajmo
li. So, the amount of benzopyrin in 1 kilogram of grilled meat is equal to amount present in 600 cigarettes. In the next 10 to 15 years, one of the things you are bound to hear is that animal protein is one of the most toxic nutrients of all that can be considered. The risk for disease goes up dramatically when even a little animal protein is added to the diet. Dr. Campbell again.
Da, i to je jedan od zaključaka one čuvene kineske
studije. This is one of the conclusions of the famous Chinese study.
I kada govorimo o malignim bolestima,
so when we talk about malignant diseases,
treba da znamo ovu činjenicu.
We should remember before take note of this fact. Food poisoning is the biggest single cause of cancer.
Najveći pojedinačni faktor za nastanak malignih bolesti.
So the single biggest cause of cancer is food poisoning.
Odavno su urađena istraživanja.
Long time ago the studies had been done.
I ja bih vam nešto od tih istraživanja pokazao.
And I'd like to show you some of these studies. Vegetarians had lower incidence of the following cancers compared to non-vegetarians. Colon, lung, breast, prostate, bladder, pancreatic. This is the source, is the journal of the American Dietetics Association from 2009-2016 and also American Journal of Clinical Nutrition in September 1999. These are the reputable sources.
Yeah. I evo jedan grafikon.
There is a graph or a diagram.
Šta je ovdje vidimo?
What do we see here?
Učestalost. So
the red columns is percentage of deaths from heart disease and cancer.
Da. A ovo pokazuje
the green column is percentage of calories from unrefined plant foods.
I pogledaj šta se dešava.
Look what happens.
Što više mi unosimo,
the higher intake of the unrefined plant foods.
Šta se dešava?
What happens with the
sa kancerom i sa kardiovaskularnim diseases?
With cancer and cardiovascular disease, what happens with them? There are decreasing, coming down.
Veoma ubedljiva
i jasno se. Convincing, very clear picture. The longest epidemiological study done on vegetarians showed they are generally less likely to suffer from all malignant diseases.
Znači, to je danas jasno i tu više
nema. This is a well-established fact today.
Postoji jasna relacija između ishrane I kancera.
There's a clear relationship between nutrition and cancer.
Ja bih vam prikazao, ja bih vam samo kratko upoznao sa jednom studijom.
I'd like to briefly introduce one study. The study included 34,000 Adventists in California. None of these Adventists smoke, drink alcohol or coffee, and do not use pork.
To je veoma značajno.
This is very important.
Znači, svi imaju, znači imaju I konstantno, znači nikada, da bi mogli da znamo kako ishrana deluje na maligne bolesti.
So to know how the diet affects the malignant diseases.
Mi moramo naći grupu gdje niko ne puši, niko ne pije.
So we have to find a group where no one is drinking, smoking, eating certain foods.
Jedina razlika je da li jedu meso, ne jedu meso.
The only difference is whether they eat meat or don't eat meat. Now, two groups were formed out of this one group. Those who do not eat meat and those who eat meat, excluding pork. Study results. Vegetarians had a lower incidence of certain cancer compared to non-vegetarians. And again, colon, lungs, breast, prostate, bladder, pancreatic.
I danas se svi slažu.
And today everyone agrees.
Po pitanju savremenih bolesti, malignih bolesti.
With respect to modern chronic malignant diseases. A vegetarian diet is recommended for the prevention of malignant diseases, particularly with regard to fat intake and dietetic fiber.
Ko to kaže?
Who says that?
Dr. Ivanov.
Dr. Ivanov.
I njegov prevodilac kum.
And his translator.
I moj kum.
My best man.
Pater Lutis, yeah?
No. The American Institute for Cancer Research and the World Cancer Research Fund, American Cancer Society.
To vodeće institucije za borbu protiv kancera.
World-leading institutions.
Šta kažu?
War against cancer.
What ne kažu to direktno, ali nam kažu. Hranite se bilo tamo.
They're telling us, use plant food.
I eat. Moći ćete I prevenirat ćete I učinit ćete bitan preventivni korak u borbi protiv malignih bolesti.
You will make significant step in prevention of malignant diseases.
Jedan opasan mit po pitanju proteina danas postoji.
There is a dangerous myth about the use of protein.
I zbog toga,
and therefore,
mi imamo ne samo probleme na našem telu,
we have problems not only in our body,
mi imamo probleme I u našoj duši.
We also have a problem in our soul.
Koji su efekti ishrane
What are the effects of
naše emocije,
on our emotions,
na naše raspoloženje,
our mood,
odnosno na sintezu moždanih hormona?
On the synthesis of brain hormones. Meat, animal proteins, prevent the entry of tryptophan and tyrosine into the brain, leading to deficiency of dopamine and serotonin in the brain.
Moram da vam dam jednu kratku informaciju.
I have to give you a very short information.
Između mozga I krvi postoji jedan zid.
Between the brain and krvi.
Da.
And the blood, there is a wall.
Zove se
partition.
Hematoencefalična barijera.
Hematoencephalic barrier.
Na tom zidu postoje vrata.
And on that wall, on that particular, there is a door.
Jedna specijalna vrata za aminoacid.
Door for amino acids.
Aminoacid tryptofan.
So amino acid tryptofan
I tirozin
and tyrosine
su male aminoacid.
So these are small amino acids.
I oni mogu da prođu bez problema kroz ta vrata.
And they can easily pass through the door.
Aminoacid iz mesa, from meat.
But amino acids from meat.
To su krupne amino acid.
These are very large amino acid blocks.
I one hoće da prođu kroz ta vrata.
And they also tend to go through the door.
Ali suviše su velike.
But they're too big.
Krenu.
They move.
Zaglave se.
They jam.
Get stuck.
I get stuck, yeah.
Začepe, zatvore.
Yeah. They simply close the door.
I onda.
What happens?
Tirozin I tryptofan.
So tyrosine and tryptophan.
Iz krvi ne mogu da uđu.
From the blood cannot penetrate, enter into the brain. Into blood, into the brain, right?
Da. I onda nastaje deficit dopamina I serotonina.
And then we develop a deficit of dopamine and serotonin.
Zovete?
You understand?
Meso sadrži krupne aminoacide.
Meat contains large amino acid.
Koje zatvore kanale
jam, close bells, those
doors,
which very important amino acids have to enter in the brain,
koje su male,
and this door is small, right?
I od kojih se sintetišu moždani hormoni.
And from which you synthesize brain hormones.
I kad osobe jedu puno mesa,
and when people eat a lot of meat,
koncentracija dopamina I serotonina u mozgu pada.
Concentration of levels of dopamine and serotonin simply go down.
Neko sreći pa šta mogu?
Somebody may say, well, so what?
Imam nešto drugo ili...
It's something else.
Šta sad, ako nemam dopamin?
So if I don't have dopamine,
šta će se desiti?
So what will happen? So deficiency of dopamine leads to A, irrational thinking, B, memory impairment, and C, even paranoia.
Deficit dopamina.
Deficit of dopamine.
Pravi ozbiljne probleme.
Causes serious problems. So once again, rational thinking, memory impairment, and paranoia.
A kad imamo dovoljno dopamina.
And if we have enough dopamine,
šta se dešava?
What happens? Creates a sense of pleasure.
Dopamin kad se luči u mozgu, mi se osjećamo fino.
When dopamine is released in the brain, we feel great.
Blaženo.
We are, very happy.
Ali da bi se dopamin stvorio.
But for dopamine to be synthesized,
moramo paziti što jedemo.
We need to watch what we eat.
Posebno odakle uzimamo proteine.
From where, especially from where we take.
Idemo da imamo još efektiva.
Let's see another effect of dopamine. Participants in the control of emotional. Oh, it participates in the control of emotional reactions, helps with pain.
Pomaže nam da
it helps us
kontrolu nad našim emocijama.
That we have control over our emotions.
I to je veoma važno.
That's also very important.
Rekli smo da unos animalnih proteina kroz mesnu hranu.
So we mentioned that intake of animal proteins through
animal proteins through meat.
So we take all animal proteins of animals' origin through meat.
Da, pravi deficit ne samo dopamina nego I serotonina.
Causes a deficit of not only dopamine but also serotonin.
Šta je posljedica toga?
So what is the consequence of that? Serotonin deficiency leads to anxiety, moodiness, and depression.
Ovo su najfrekventniji problemi ljudske duše danas.
These are most acute problems of human soul today.
Deficit serotonina.
Deficit of serotonin.
Izaziva
anxiousness, anxiety,
and depression.
Moodiness, depression.
Ako podignemo koncentraciju.
So if we elevate the levels of serotonin.
Šta ćemo dobiti?
What shall we get?
Dobit ćemo jedno prijatno, bedro raspoloženje, jedno antidepresivno stanje.
Antidepressive mood.
Oko 40 do 45% depresije su u vezi sa greškama u ishrani.
40 to 45% of depressions are closely connected, related to this issue.
I sad čim još.
And what else?
Sa obilnom struka.
The body
waistlines.
Yeah, this is the called abdominal waistline.
Što je veći obim struka ili što je veća abdominalna bojaznost?
Yeah, the larger abdominal waist,
veća šansa da budemo deficit.
The larger chance that we would be depressive.
Serotonin je veoma važan hormon.
Serotonin is very important hormon.
On
leads to relaxation, calmness and serenity.
Da vidimo koja je hrana bogata u triptofanu.
So let's see which food is rich in tryptophan and tyrosine.
Rekli smo, tirozin je cigla od koje se pravi dopamin.
So tyrosine is a brick from which we make dopamine.
Gde se nalazi?
So where do we find tyrosine?
Lan, susam, bundevine semenke, suncokretove semenke.
Black seed.
Black seed. Sunflower seeds and sesame seeds
and pumpkin
seeds. That's right.
Također nuts.
Also nuts. Walnut.
I šta još? Makunarke.
And also legumes. Legumes.
Ove namirnice sadrže tirozin.
So these these food items contain tyrosine.
Tu malo aminu kiselinu.
This small amino acid,
koja protrči
kroz ona vrata the door and
između krvi i brena.
Between the bloodstream and the brain.
Istovremeno ove namirnice ne sadrže krupne molekule koje će zaglaviti
ova plant food items do not contain these large molecules that will brain block jam.
Gde se nalazi triptofan?
So where do you find tryptophan?
Triptofan se nalazi u
it's found in
negdje u polenu.
In honey and honey from pollen.
U celom zrnu žitarica, whole
grains.
U banani.
Bananas.
U nacu.
Nuts, there is nuts.
I u leguminozama.
And the legumes.
Ako hoćemo da imamo prijatno raspoloženje.
If you want to have a very pleasant state of mind and mood.
Fokusiramo se na bile namirnice.
Focus on the plant foods.
A klonimo se mesa, mesnih proizvoda.
Put away meat and animal products. So healthy natural food is the key to achieving superior mental capabilities.
Još jedna važna stvar.
One more thing, important thing.
Ako hoćemo da vozimo auto,
if you want to drive a car,
i da idemo negde,
and to go somewhere,
mi pre nego što krenemo na put,
before we go on the trip,
šta radimo?
What do we do?
Odemo na benzinsku pumpu.
We went to the gas station, go to a gas station.
I napunimo automobil.
Fill up the tank.
Gorivom, odnosno izvorom energije.
So we have a source of energy. We put the fuel in the tank.
Right? Mi smo se ujutro probudili.
So we wake up in the morning.
Treba da idemo radimo ceo dan.
We have to work the whole day.
Treba nam za posao ne samo mišići i ruke.
We need for work not only our hands, arms and muscles.
Da bi radili treba i mozak da uključimo.
Work, we need also to use the brain.
Mozak kao izvor energije.
So the brain as for the source of energy.
Koristi šta?
What?
Slaninu.
Oh, this is
bacon.
That's right.
Da.
Thank you.
Zatim ovu jetru, salame.
Yeah, liver, salami.
Šta još?
Krvavice.
One, da kažem, sladoled.
Cup ice creams.
No.
I apologize, I'm vegetarian, I don't know the names of all the meat products.
Znači, mozak kao izvor energije.
So, brain for the source of energy
koristi isključivo
uses exclusively
prirodnu glukozu.
Natural glucose.
Prirodna glukoza je najbolji izvor energije za rad naše
mozga. So, natural glucose is the best source of energy for the brain.
I kada ustanemo,
and when we get up,
treba da uzmemo med,
so we should take some honey,
i da uzmemo neko voće,
and to take some fruits.
Nemojmo otići iz naših domova, iz naših kuća,
let's not leave our homes,
a da ne uzmemo
without
glukozu iz voća i iz meda.
Without taking some glucose from honey and from fruits.
U mesu nema glukoze.
So in meat you don't have any glucose.
Daj da čujemo ovog gospodina.
Let's hear this gentleman, what he has to say. It's easier to break an atom than human error.
Lakše je razbiti atom nego ljudske predrasude i zablude.
Yes. That's right, I just...
Kaže čovjek koji je bio vegetarijan.
Said a man, this is said by a man who was a vegetarian. Where do you get your protein from? Yes, I'm a vegan. Would you like to discuss with me where I get my protein?
Or?
Would you like to, I'm vegan too, would you like to discuss with me where I get my protein?
Šta kažu ljudi?
So, people, what do people say?
Ako hoću da imam snage,
I want to have energy,
ako hoću da budem velik,
to be big,
treba da jedem animalne proteine.
I have to eat animal proteins.
Koja je zabluda?
This is an error. Error.
Životinski svijet kaže...
The animal world tells us that this is not true. Plant proteins can provide all our body's protein and energy needs. American Athletic Association. athletes can also meet all their protein needs through a plant-based diet. American Journal of Clinical Nutrition. Legumes, beans are ideal sources of protein.
Ja kad sam završio medicinu,
when I completed my studies in medical school,
to je bilo pre 30,
it was about 30,
33
years ago,
ja sam onda upisao postdiplomske studije.
And I entered into graduate studies in medicine.
I uzeo sam da ispitujem vegetarijanstvo.
And I did my research.
I aterosklerozu.
I was researching the research on vegetarianism and atherosclerosis.
U to vreme,
in that time,
to je pre 1990. godine.
This is before 1990s.
Ovo? Ovo nije pisalo u udžbenicima.
This was not. You could not find the statements in the textbooks in nutrition schools.
Pisalo nešto drugo.
It was something else. Something else was written then.
Ljudi su otišli, ljudi često odu zavu, naprave pogrešne naučne zaključke.
We humans, we often go in the wrong ways and make wrong conclusions.
Pa naprave i greške u oblasti medicine i ishrane.
So they make errors. Errors also in the field of medicine.
I mnoge druge greške prave u svom životu.
And many other errors in life.
Jer su zapostavili.
Because they have neglected.
Knjigu koja je izvor mudrosti.
The book which is the true source of wisdom.
Prolaze razne ideje, pojavljuju se, nestanu, mnogi filozofi, neki zaključi se pojave.
Philosophers, thinkers come and go.
Ali,
but,
ono što piše u Bibliji,
what is written in the Bible,
to traje.
This is what lasts.
To vreme ne može nikada da pregazi
niti da. Time not make it obsolete.
I evo što kaže Biblija u Hristu.
And what does the Bible say about the food and diet? I read from Genesis 1:29. And God said, behold, I have given you every herb bearing seed, which is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree, in the which is the fruit of tree yielding seed. To you it shall be for food.
Da, to je istina. Najjezgrovitija, najjednostavnija i najistinitija istina po pitanju naše ishrane.
The most essential, the most basic, the most fundamental truth about our diet is here. Position of the American and Canadian Dietetics Association. We well-planned vegetarian diets are appropriate for all stages of human life cycle, including pregnancy, lactation, and all periods of childhood. This is from American Dietetics Association 2003. Eat fruits and vegetables and wash them well.
Evo kaže, pa i biljke su zagađene.
Some people say, oh, well, plants are also contaminated.
Ali mi koji se bavimo ishranom.
But we who deal with professional diet.
Šta mi kaže? Jedite biljke.
Eat plants.
Ali ih upelite.
But wash them.
Nemojte ih izbjegavati.
Don't avoid them.
Ako hoćete zdravo da se hranite.
If you want to eat healthy, wait.
Šta treba raditi?
What you should do.
Najbolje da sami kuvate hranu.
The best thing to do is that you prepare your own food. Cook your own food.
I evo ja sam zaista imao tu privilegiju.
I really had a privilege.
Da dobijem poziv da dođem u Hamilton.
To receive the invitation to come to Hamilton.
I ja sam, kao kažem, meni je bilo posebno drago da sam mogao da vas vidim ovdje.
It has been my great pleasure to see you all here.
I da ovih nekoliko dana.
And these few days.
Razmišljamo o našem zdravlju.
That we can think seriously about our health.
Činjenica da zdravlje nije sve.
A fact of life is that health is not everything. There's one statement here. Health is not everything, but without health, everything is nothing.
I zato,
and therefore,
svakog dana,
every day,
mi kao slobodno biće biramo.
We as free human beings with free choice, we choose.
Birajući postupke i životni stil.
Choosing actions, lifestyle.
Mi u stvari biramo zdravlje ili bolest.
In reality, we choose life or health or disease.
Zdravlje je rezultat mudrih izbora.
Health is a result of wise choices.
Kada biramo,
when we choose,
birajmo,
let's choose
život,
life
i zdravlje.
And health.
I poruka za doktora Ivanova.
A message for Dr. Ivanov.
Jeste da je vreme da završim predavanje.
Time to close.
Hvala na pažnji.
Thank you so much for attention.